Finally, Buhari will be leaving as UN concludes his resignation. See for yourself. The United Kingdom, UK, United States, US, and France were gathered to be purportedly advising President Muhammadu Buhari to resign from office following noticeable inability to provide leadership for the government of Nigeria and the attendant economic and security crisis. Sources from the Nigerian presidency, who sought anonymity, disclosed that the three nations have been purportedly deliberated on the health of the president, which they considered a major factor constraining him from effective leadership of the country. The presidency sources further disclosed that President Buhari, who departed Nigeria for France on Sunday, may be holding talks in Paris with the medical team from Britain on his health situation to consider the capacity to continue in office. The British medical team was alleged to have been advising the president to resign on health grounds and may be moving into Paris for consultation with the president. It also disclosed that Paris was chosen for the talks with the Nigerian president to avoid the controversies that the president's travel to London may generate. The UK, US, and France were said to have frowned at the frequency of kidnapping in Nigeria by bandits and the processes that some governors and leaders in the north adopt to secure the release of schools after days of weeks of the kidnap and the ransoms paid for their freedom. They were also said to be uncomfortable with the roles of certain non-state actors in the negotiation for the release of kidnapped victims after ransom payment, noting that such practice may be contributing to the consistent kidnapping which the Nigerian government has been finding difficult to tackle. The big powers were further said to be disturbed by the lingering insecurity crisis, which has been affecting the economy, complaining that the deteriorating situation has been affected their investment and business interest in Nigeria. They were said to have the belief that the president may have lost control of the government due to his health situation. The presidency sources disclosed that the three big power purportedly held similar consultation with former President Goodluck Jonathan in 2015 before the general election, where they were alleged to have told the former president to leave office. They were said to have acknowledged during the consultation with the former Nigerian president that they were aware that a general election was going to be held, but insisted that he should leave office after the election, notwithstanding the results, allegedly threatening that if he had remained after the election, they cannot say what would follow. The three nations were said to be complaining that things were bad before 2015, which made them move for the former president's exit from office, but that the situation is worse now. Multiple faults under the current leadership, like, and follow for a quick update. You see, even the UK too, they are aware. They are aware that we made a mistake. They too also pushed for the exit of Goodluck Jonathan, unknown to them that the very government that they are throwing support for is going to be the worst government. Everybody believed in Buhari. Everybody trusted Buhari. They know, they were feeling that at least as a one-time military leader, he will know how to go about trapping these godforsaken Boko people. Unknown to us that we are just seeing an empty sheet of paper. Yes, that was what we saw at the end of the day. We end up seeing an empty sheet of paper. We never knew that the person we are putting all our hope on is going to disappoint us. Look at, see what has happened. Okay, so what are we going to do now? What are we going to do? In fact, everything is too disturbing. Quite disturbing. Worry gave us a false hope. He even went on to brag and noise that 90 days is even too much for him to close the chapter of the Boko people. Can you imagine? That, and I think that alone gave the people a lot of confidence and courage that this guy is good to go. Yes, that was what made a lot of people to give him the support. That was what jeered a lot of people and make them believe that this guy is the right guy. Look at the right guy. See what the right guy have cost us. You see, you don't judge a book by the cover. You know, the content of that book is what matters. The same thing goes to you, man. It's not the facial expression of a human that determine the true person of the human, but the inbuilt person of that human, the heart of that human. How good is that person in heart? You understand? Some person may appear to be innocent, good looking, and all that, but inside they are the devil incarnate, and that is Buhari. He's having a very innocent and decent look, but inside he is another person entirely. You will not even believe it. You won't believe it. So look at. So that is why I just keep laughing whenever anything of this such happens. I just, okay. That's what I do say. That's what I do say, because we all contributed to our suffering. Even I too, I contributed, because we all said we wanted change, and now the change is now what is now changing us. Since we cannot change the change is now changing us. Yes, that is it. So let us enjoy it. Let us have a feel of it. Let us have a feel of the punishment, because that is what we call for. That's what we call for. We are the one that removed Jonathan, saying that we want Buhari. Hey, they have given us Buhari. Let's make do with him now. Mm-hmm. Yes. So what is the tears for? What is the tears for? So let us celebrate. Abi. Mm-hmm. Let us celebrate. You see, one thing about Nigerians is that we don't accept the truth. The truth is too bitter for us to accept. Too bitter for us to accept. And it is killing us by the day. It keeps killing us. We don't like hearing the truth. We don't like hearing the truth. When people tell us the truth, we believe that the person is telling us a lie. That's what we think. And that's why we keep, you know, going backward. Yes, we are backward. We are backward. Nigeria is not even a developed country. We are very backward. You understand? Yeah. So my dear viewers in the house, based on these very facts, what do you think? What's your own observation? What's your own thoughts about this? Because I'm perplexed. Don't forget to come in, at least let's hear you. Don't forget to click on the red subscribe button as well as the bell button to receive more updates. Thank you.